Hi there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Chay.
And I'm Ben Peltier. Again, thanks to the latest round of COVID restrictions, many social and cultural activities have come to a halt. For some, the lack of outside distractions may have provided more time for inner reflection and rediscovery. Later, guitarist Teriver Cheung, no stranger to the show, will be here to tell us how personal difficulties inspired him to take up a new path on his musical and spiritual journey.
But first, during the pandemic, nature has provided a sanctuary for many. Here in Hong Kong, country parks, mountains, and the outlying islands have been full of people, especially during the weekend, taking a break from confinement and isolation. Lamma Island is also currently the backdrop for a public art project called Lamma Mia.
For
residents of Lamma Island, ferries and other small boats are an inescapable part of life. Shum Kwan Yi likes to take the smaller Kaito ferries from Aberdeen Ferry Pier to Lamma to get a better understanding of the everyday lives of the island's residents. While taking the Kaito to Lamma Island, Shum Kwan Yi noticed that the boat passed many different vessels. Inspired by this, she created six different types of toy boats and placed them in the forecourt of Lamma's Tinhau Tempo at Sok Hu Wan. Visitors or local residents, particularly children, can pilot the boats through an imaginary sea.
Shum
Kwan Yi is one of 15 artists currently exhibiting works focusing on Lamma Island and the lifestyle of its residents. The artists are all taking part in the public art project Lamma Mia, organized by the Art Promotion Office of Leisure and Cultural Services Department. Their works at Sok Hu Wan in South Lamma include sculptures of Sok Hu Wan dogs, a community farm, photos capturing the traces of waves, and a natural camera obscura created right outside the local tourist attraction Kamikaze Grotto. The aim is to reflect the unique history of the fishing village. Although some indoor exhibition areas have been closed temporarily in accordance with government social distancing guidelines, visitors can still see some of the outdoor works. Indian-Filipino artist Sharu B. Sigdar asked residents to collect banana leaves growing on the islands and work with her on creating pinwheels with them. For her, the pinwheels are a connection between her own roots and culture and the natural world of Lamma Island.
This place is a very beautiful place, and it's very different from the city side because everyone has a very relaxing atmosphere, and it's very easy to talk to people, and they're very friendly. And I've enjoyed my time being here on the island, and yeah, I thought it was very enjoyable to collect leaves from the island itself and as well to get to know the locals and also to create the work for this island. I was lucky to find locals who were able to welcome me to collect their banana leaves. So actually, I've been collecting banana leaves once every week for each month since the project started. So I've always went to their place to collect the banana leaves. And at the same time, while we collect banana leaves, they were also sharing like what they thought about the project. And I've also shared my own culture because they also rarely knew that you could eat the banana flower itself. Banana leaves, in my own culture, like if it's in Indian culture, it is actually quite sacred because we use banana leaves a lot in rituals and also wedding ceremonies. It is used very often because it represents prosperity, good luck, as well as good health. And so I thought about if I can use banana leaves, I can also connect it to the Chinese culture itself in terms of the pinwheels, where it also represents good luck. So in the sense of using the material of a natural material like banana leaves, as well as connecting to memory of a childhood toy that you would see now, to connect them together. I also hope that when people come and they get to turn the leaves itself, it's like turning your own luck or just have a new beginning for a better year ahead.
Working with oils, watercolors, and ink, Zao Wou-ki bridged Eastern and Western art traditions in his abstract compositions. In his own words, everybody is bound by a tradition. I'm bound by two.
Zao moved to France in 1948, where he immersed himself in modernism, impressionism, and expressionism. In the 1970s, he returned to the brush and ink technique he'd first learned in China, although he still worked in the Western abstract tradition. You can see a selection of his works that illustrate this creative tension at the Villepin Gallery in the exhibition Zao Wou-ki, The Eternal Return to China.
Welcome back. Regular viewers of the show won't need much introduction to our guest today. Guitarist and composer Teriver Cheung has been with us several times to perform and to talk about music, ranging from jazz and improvisation to classical ensembles. a prolific cross-disciplinary musician. He has worked in many different genres and with a wide array of artists. But the past couple of years has brought him a life-changing challenge, which has led him to take a new musical and spiritual path.
Well, it's a delight to have all of you here in the studio. Teriver, I'll begin with you as an old friend of the works and multiple-time guest on the show.
Thank you.
It's lovely to have you back here. And I understand that as one of the driving forces behind this overall Into the Blue project, that it comes from a very personal place for you.
Yeah.
So I'd like to begin with that aspect of it, and then let's see where we go.
So Into the Blue was one of my older piece from 2015 when I wrote it for Hong Kong episodes. So since then, I have different arrangements, different versions of it. And then since I was diagnosed with cancer 1.5 years ago, so I went through so much, and mindfulness really helped me out during the process. So now I'm able to create work again. I would like to share this experience and think about what I can do with my art to the community and the people. So Into the Blue is about getting back to the nature and just find serenity with our lives and in these very difficult situations. And I'm very lucky to have some of my partners here to do this with me. So we have Sheeter, Zoe, and Heidi. So they all are great in their own fields, and they really bring a lot on the table for this project.
So tying this idea together, Sheeta, I'll move on to you then. There's a lot going on with this.
Sure.
There are workshops, there are tea ceremonies, there's a forest walk aspect. There are actually quite a few things. So maybe take me through the thread that weaves this all together, and then maybe some of the specifics as well.
Yeah, actually why we put this experience together, I can say it's like about the experience, the giving the, under the like difficult situation, I think most of the people will like really need a space for themselves, because, lots of people nice to go out, but like not anytime. So I'm very thankful like Tycoon inviting us. So we are, and Teriver like co-create something about the experience. So we have the tea ceremony, and forest walk, and yoga, and improvisation, and also the sun healing, which is Heidi will talk about a little bit later. And also I invite Zoe like to make a like space for themselves. So that's why we have different theme to come with the whole experience.
This sort of artistic project, Zoe, is I imagine rather unique. I haven't really seen anything like this, where you're combining music on the one hand, and then with spaces and activities and mindfulness and yoga. So what has it been like working on this project as an artist coming to it from your own perspective and angle?
Actually, this is also very new to me. Why I come up with the concept, actually, I remember the time when I joined the designer residency in Hangzhou a few years ago. I lived in a village house in the countryside for 1 month. The quietness really healed my mental problem. So I want to transform the urban indoor space into a very surreal natural space in Taikun. It can be a forest or a farm, just think with your own imagination. I will build up a very huge red tent sea with weaving lots of pieces of red tent and dry plants. So everything we use is very organic and natural, so they all will go back to the soil after dismantle. And I hope people come to our space and they can have a very peaceful and calming atmosphere.
Heidi, when you try to fuse that with the idea of healing or mindfulness, what are the considerations that you have to take into account when trying to work out what a performance of that might look like?
It's actually really good. A chance for me to actually put my thoughts into realization in this project, because coming from a classical musician background, I want to combine the things that people can enjoy, like music and art, combine them with healing and the idea of mindfulness. And so when we do the guided meditation recording, we actually use some of the music motif, but then merge them with some mantras, say healing mantras, in a modern way, in a language that like modern people can relate to, so that they will be easier to dive into this experience with also the installation that will be surrounding the guided meditation. When people sit down and listen to the recording, then they will be in a weaved rattan seat. Yeah. Then it will be like a holistic experience for audience and participants.
Due to the pandemic, we're not really sure when we're going to see the full realization of this project come out, but it is definitely on the way, so look out for it on your calendars to be sure. But to give us a taste, if people are intrigued by what you've all been telling me, what can we hear or experience here in the studio to share with our audience?
Today we are going to do a very short version of a guided breathing exercise with some jazz improvisation by Heidi and myself. So I hope you will get a taste of what's going to happen, and you will check out Into the Blue series.
So find a comfortable place and try to take part if you can, I guess.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you so much, Ben.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sit in a comfortable position with your back straight. Gently breathe in with your nose. Fill your chest with fresh air and slowly breathe out with your mouth. Breathe in with your nose. This time, hold your breath. Put a smile to your heart and gently exhale. Again, breathe in with your nose, slowly and gently. Put a smile to your heart and exhale with your mouth. Breathe in with your nose. Put a smile to your heart. Take your time and slowly breathe out. For the last time, slowly breathe in with your nose. Put a smile to your heart. Breathe out. Keep a natural rhythm of your breath close your eyes and feel the gentleness in your heart. Return the attention to your breath. Feel your body. Gently move your fingers and toes. And